If you pray the nights of Ramadan, you'll be forgiven. If you witness Laylatul Qadr, you'll be forgiven. So many opportunities for us to be forgiven, inshallah. The question that we need to ask ourselves, why? Why are you here tonight? Why are you here instead of laying on your couch watching TV? Why are you here instead of laying in your bed and falling asleep? Why you're here instead of going to the restaurant, to the coffee shop, or watch a game or play video games? Why are we here? Why are you fasting for 16 hours every day? What is the purpose of us doing all this? If someone asks you this question on college campus or at work, why do you torture yourself? Why do you go through all that? What is the benefit? And the answer, even though there are so many benefits of fasting and so many benefits for Qiyam, but we do this for one ultimate goal, which is to go to Jannah. That's why we fast. That's why we stand up for a couple of hours every night praying, because we are hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get us into Jannah. We spend money, we give donations, we could have just kept it for ourselves. Why do we do that? Because we want to go to Jannah. All these things that we do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're hoping that it will get us a place in Jannah. Now, as we all know, Jannah has many beautiful things in it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ Those who are protected from the fire and enter into Jannah, they are the true winners. They are the true winners. We all like to win and we all like to succeed. Does anyone like to fail? Do you like to fail when you do a project? Do you like to fail when you work? Do you like to fail when you go? No, we all like to succeed in life. Now, what is the Islamic term for the word success? Anyone knows? It's mentioned in the Quran. It's mentioned in the Adhan. What is the word for success? Falah. Absolutely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not use a word to describe success and winning in the Quran more than the word falah. Yesterday when we start reciting Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the people who believe in Prophet Muhammad and the prophets before him, those who pray, those who pay zakah, those who believe in the Day of Judgment, he said, وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ Those are the true successful people. There is over 40 spots in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word aflaha or falah. What I would like to do, I'll be here inshallah with you every Thursday night, is choose some of these things that we can do so we can be considered muflihun, so we can be considered among those who are successful. The example that we just said right now, the first time Allah mentioned falah in the Quran, in the first page of Surah Al-Baqarah. You want to be successful? You believe in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You believe in the prophets before him. You believe in the Day of Judgment. You pray and you pay your zakah. That is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the path to success. And that's exactly what we're trying to do. When we fast 16 hours, when we come to the masjid for a few hours, we want to be successful. We want to succeed in this life and in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that those who will win on the Day of Judgment sometimes have to go through difficulties in this life. They have to be dealing with people who are making fun of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Mu'minun, إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِي يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا آمَنَّا فَاغْفِرْ لَنَا وَارْحَمْنَا So there are a group of people used to say, we believed, Ya Allah, so forgive us. So the evil people, what did they do? فَاتَّخَذْتُمُوهُمْ سِخْرِيًّا حَتَّى أَنْسَوْكُمْ ذِكْرِي You made fun of them. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end? إني جزيتهم اليوم بما صبروا أنهم هم الفائزون. I give them the reward for being patient, for putting up with everything that you did to them, that they will be the winners on the day of judgment. So I'm hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will confirm us in this month among the winners. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every night in Ramadan, Allah will confirm certain number of people to be among the people of Jannah. So if we are chosen tonight, if we have been given this honor to be confirmed among the people of Jannah, the rest of your life, you'll act like the people of Jannah. This is one of the best du'as that you can do in Ramadan, that Ya Allah, make me among the ones whom you choose this night to be among the people of Jannah, to be among those who succeed, those who do falah. When we hear the adhan, the muadhan says, Hayya ala al-falah, come to success. That's what you should have thinking about, that I want to succeed. I want to be successful. Because success is not about being a millionaire. Success is not about all being straight A's in school. Success is not about opening a business. Success, the true success, is to be in Jannah. All that is good success, but the actual success that we're looking for as Muslims is Jannah. Even if I live as poor all my life, I want to go to Jannah. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who succeed in this life and the hereafter, to make us among those who will be granted a place, a spot in Jannah this Ramadan, insha'Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه جزاكم الله خيرا.
استوي إلى الصلاة أثابني وأثابكم الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقولوا راعنا وقولوا انظرنا واسمعوا وللكافرين عذاب أليم. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم والله يختص برحمته من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم. ما ننسخ من آية أو ننسها نأتي بخير منها أو مثلها ألم تعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير. ألم تعلم أن الله له ملك السماوات والأرض وما لكم من دون الله من ولي ولا نصير. أم تريدون أن تسألوا رسولكم كما سئل موسى من قبل؟ ومن يتبدل الكفر بالإيمان فقد ضل سواء السبيل ود كثير من أهل الكتاب لو يردونكم من بعد إيمانكم كفارا حسدا من عند أنفسهم من بعد ما تبين لهم الحق فاعفوا واصفحوا حتى يأتي الله بأمره إن الله على كل شيء قدير وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله إن الله بما تعملون بصير وقالوا لن يدخل الجنة إلا من كان هودا أو نصارى تلك أمانيهم قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين بلى من أسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن فله أجره عند ربه ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين وقالت اليهود ليست النصارى على شيء وقالت النصارى ليست اليهود على شيء وهم يتلون الكتاب كذلك قال الذين لا يعلمون مثل قولهم فالله يحكم بينهم يوم القيامة فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون ومن أظلم ممن منع مساجد الله أن يذكر فيها اسمه وسعى في خرابها أولئك ما كان لهم أن يدخلوها إلا خائفين لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم ولله المشرق والمغرب فأينما تولوا فثم وجه الله إن الله واسع عليم وقالوا اتخذ الله ولدا سبحانه بل له ما في السماوات والأرض كل له قانتون بديع السماوات والأرض وإذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فإنما يقول له كن فيكون. وقال الذين لا يعلمون لولا يكلمنا الله أو تأتينا آية، كذلك قال الذين من قبلهم مثل قولهم، تشابهت قلوبهم، قد بينا الآيات لقوم يوقنون. إنا أرسلناك بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا، ولا تسأل عن أصحاب الجحيم. ولن ترضى عنك اليهود ولا النصارى حتى تتبع ملتهم، قل إن هدى الله هو الهدى، ولئن اتبعت أهواءهم بعد الذي جاءك من العلم ما لك من الله من ولي ولا نصير. الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يتلونه حق تلاوته أولئك يؤمنون به، ومن يكفر به فأولئك هم الخاسرون. يا بني إسرائيل اذكروا نعمتي التي أنعمت عليكم وأني فضلتكم على العالمين. واتقوا يوما لا تجزي نفس عن نفس شيئا ولا يقبل منها عدل ولا تنفعها شفاعة ولا هم ينصرون.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم.